Okay, welcome to my channel for the next video. Today we are going to discuss about how you can install a water block into your processor, right? So you can see my processor is here. Okay, this processor has installed a EKWB quantum velocity water block. You might be able to find a lot of brands for these water blocks and a lot of variations within one brand as well. So if you go for EKWB brand, you might be able to find different variations for the same type of processor water block. The mine is Intel 10th Gen processor, LGA1200, but the EKW has water blocks for almost all the other processor types as well, including AMD processors. But installation process may be slightly different when it comes to AMD processors. But once you watch this video, so you will be able to install a water block into AMD processor as well, because it is a little bit different, but it is not too much different than this water block installation.
First of all, let's see how we can purchase a right EKW CPU water block from EKW.com. There are a lot of options you can see. But if you really want to find the water block matches your CPU, you can navigate to this URL. I will put this URL in the description as well. So you navigate to this URL and then you might be able to find these options. So under that, you have to click this motherboard, because all these water blocks actually designed with your motherboard brand, not dedicated for the CPU itself. So in my case, I have Asus and it's a 10th gen processor, so LGA1200, as well as I have this motherboard. So I selected that and then it will show me list of water blocks which will work with my motherboard as well as the processor. For me, I have this quantum velocity water block. So if you click view, so it will take you to the purchasing options, or you can click this link. It will give you some kind of a image of the water block, so you can have a look at it. This quantum magnitude one, this is a highly customizable water block. But if you're really interested, you can have this kind of a wooden finish water blocks as well. They're really cool. But I want to show you a different type of water block in Gigabyte motherboard. So if you select these options like it in here, so you can see a different type of water block. Above you can see all these normal water blocks, but in the bottom you can see this mono block option. If you click this view link, you can see how it is look like. It is a quite big water block. Normal water block size comes within this area, but this is little bigger than that. This one is called mono block. These actually cool down not only your processor but also your VRMs means like your voltage regulator module. So usually the motherboard has heat sinks to cool down your VRMs, but this water block will offer you to cool your VRMs also using liquid cooling method. But unfortunately, this water block supports only few motherboard types up to now. Okay, now let's see how we can install the selected water block into your processor. Let's go inside and see what are the things it comes with this particular water block. As you can see here, it has some screws, some springs and some washers to fix this water block into your motherboard, as well as the water block itself. And usually EKWB provide thermal paste also along with this water block. If you check the front side of this water block, you can see water inlet and outlet they have mentioned, and it has a cable that powers up LEDs inside this water block. Okay, so now let's see how we can get this installed in your motherboard. First of all, you have to turn your motherboard other side, then you have to get this rubber washer, but this one comes with some middle part as well, so I have already removed that part. You don't need it in this installation. So you get this rubber portion and place it correctly, then you have to get this metal plate and place it correctly, so you can align your metal plate with this screw heads, so you won't miss that as well. But the side, you have to make sure it has to be in this side. Then you have to turn the motherboard into other side by holding all these parts behind. Then you can get washers first. So you have to install the washers, then you have to get this kind of a screw, and then you have to tighten up that back plate into your motherboard using these screws. So in this case, you might need to move the hand in the bottom a little bit in order to align these screws with the holes in the back plate. So you have to install 4 screws in order to secure this back plate. Once all 4 screws are tightened up properly, then you can add the thermal paste. When you're adding the thermal paste, don't add too much of thermal paste into the processor. You can follow any technique you like, but don't add too much thermal paste. Then you have to remove the sticker in the back side of the CPU water block, and then you can place it nicely. But in this placement, you can install any side, it doesn't matter, but generally it installed in vertical way. That means these two water inlet and outlet in vertical manner. But if you want, you can rotate it in 90 degree and you can install it horizontally. If you install this water block with 90 degree angle, it called as goofy orientation. If you install this processor water block in goofy orientation, it will reduce the thermal performance just by 1 Celsius or 2 Celsius max. So you don't need to worry about this orientation too much. Once you place this water block nicely, then you can place these springs and then these 4 thumb screws to tighten this motherboard water block into your processor. When you are tightening up these thumb screws, make sure you are tightening up 1 or 2 at a time in like cross fashion. Don't tighten just one screw up to the end, and please don't use any screwdriver in order to tighten this up. One more thing, and if your processor is LGA2011 kind of processor, so then you have to do one more thing before this water block installation. You have to change this jet before this water block installation. But all these things are actually mentioned in your guide, so make sure to refer this guide before the installation. Okay, once this installation is done, so it will be look like this. Depending upon your orientation you have selected. And that's all guys. So now this one is ready for the next installation step.